Hey, Greg, you wish for a little more action?
I do wish for more action, Mike.
As you wish, Greg. Let's party! Greg, we're just getting started. Get two wishes left.
Boxing King Media in association with Boxer Delight. How with me? Up and coming cruiserweight Vidal Riley. Vidal, great to see you. We're seeing each other a lot nowadays. How are we keeping?
I'm good, man. I'm good. I'm feeling inspired after tonight. You know, big cruiserweight main event for the British title. I got the English title, but I feel like next fight I'd love to fight Chamberlain. People would say have a few and all of this stuff, but come on, we're in the game to fight, man. We're in the game to fight, and if it's a fight you believe you can win, what's the stalling? What's the need? There's no point in me being online calling out Tommy Fury and then when there's people within my realm who I think I can win against. This is no disrespect to Isaac, by the way. I really respect Isaac as a person and as a fighter. But I just think it's part of the game. We're in the game to fight. The natural progression from English is British. I know he's operated at a higher level, but we know that I also bring the following that some people even higher than me don't have. And this game's about making money and having big fights. And I think my audience would be happy to see me in a fight where they're not 100% certain I would win. Some people might write me off. I love that. So, I'd like to have that as the next fight. Maybe early next year or something. And it's really established myself as the fighter I know I am.
I mean, I just spoke to Johnny Nelson. He also said the same thing. He said, I've spoke to Vidal, told Vidal that that'd be a great fight for you now. It'd be a great chess fight, chess match.
Yeah, I think it would be a good chess match because Chamberlain is a good boxer. But I think I got a bit more than him. And obviously he's got experience on his side and he's been in there with some high-level guys. But I've also boxed a lot longer in general. You know, you hear him say he has 9 amateur fights. I had, 55 amateur fights, international and travelled. And, you know, so things equal itself out. I know the amateur game is not the same as a pro, but the game of being in boxing, I've been in the game for a long time. And I feel like I need a name for people to give me that true respect as a fighter. Winning the English was a start, but it's just exciting. Let's make things exciting. Now, me versus Chamberlain is exciting.
I mean, would you be, if Ben said the fight's available next, you'll jump next?
Yeah, I said to Ben, I said, I would like to fight the winner of the main event tonight. He said, you don't have to. I said, I know I don't have to, but we're here to challenge ourselves. We're here to challenge ourselves. Well, I am anyway. I am. I'm here to change myself within reason and be smart. And I think, like, it just adds up. It adds up.
I saw you speaking to Chris Billum-Smith, who's currently the WBO Cruiserweight Champion. He's got no plans of going to heavyweight. His weight is a cruiserweight. Any discussions there? Any?
No, man. Me and Chris just have a respect for each other. We're just discussing the action and just discussing, you know, a night of boxing. I don't look at Chris as an opponent to think about right now. You know, he's at the top of the hill, he's world champion. I'm looking more in a realistic realm, which is the British. And it just so happens that Chamberlain's a very good British champion because he's competed at a higher level. So it sounds good to me, man. Don't it sound good? Don't you think it sounds good?
I think it's good. I think fighters, if they think that they're good enough, that they should test themselves and not be afraid to lose.
Yeah, I'm not going to listen to everyone else on what they think. I know what I can do. My team knows what I can do. And if me and my team didn't believe in what we're saying, I wouldn't come here today and say it. So just is the way it is. But I want Chamberlain to enjoy the victory and enjoy the win. And then he might have to see me next year smiling. And we hopefully have a classic and a good war.
From the shenanigans of last week in Manchester to here in London, just if there's one or two pointers that boxing can learn from misfits, what would that be?
You know what? I'm not sure in that way because last week was a massive show. Like last week was like it's like a Mayweather-Pacquiao size show. Do you know what I mean? So Misfits actually have a show coming up in York Hall. So they clearly still got their bit to do. But you know the guys promote well. The guys promote well and they show their personality, they show their character, the same old stuff that we've been talking about for ages. But it doesn't mean that everyone in that room is famous. It doesn't mean that everyone in that room makes a lot of money. So sometimes we have to look at the fact that Misfits, the same company that is selling out AO Arena, also have a show your pool size. So it goes to show things balance out, and it's only the stars of each realm that manage to get that level.
Fury and Ngannou next week, quick prediction, how that fight plays out?
Fury to outbox him and make a ton of bread.
Obviously part of 258 and Anthony Joshua's kind of management structure. He's gone into a retreat where he's spending some time alone without his phone for a few days. What more can you tell us? And is that something that you might even consider?
Not something I've thought of. I can't tell you any more than the tweet that Michael Benson put out. That's the only way I found out about it. I mean, if that's what he wants to do, let him do what he wants to do. But yeah, it's not a big, like, big report within the team. Oh yeah, he's going on a retreat. It's a grown man, isn't it? He can do what he wants.
But that's going to finish on Misfits. Obviously, when I spoke to you probably a year ago, you said to me Jake Paul was at the throne of Misfits. He took that L to Tommy. KSI would then beat Joe Fournier. That was called a draw. Now KSI takes that loss. Where does KSI go next? I'm not sure if Tommy is going to have that rematch with him. Is it automatic that we see Jake Paul KSI next?
I hope so, mate. I hope so, don't you? I hope so. I don't want to really see a Tommy and JJ rematch. I'd rather us just see the fight that we've all been waiting to see. And then, yeah, man, we can go from there. But it's time to see that fight, you know. It's time to see that. There's only so long you're dragging it out. I just want to see Jake versus JJ. I've been wanting to see that since 2018, 2019. So hopefully it finally happens.
Vidal, appreciate time. Be safe, be well. Catch up with you soon.
Thank you.